I voted for Olusegun Obasanjo. I voted for Buhari the first time around. When I saw that that first 4 years didn't work, I didn't vote for him the second time. In the absence of good and bad, between PDP and APC, I looked at Buhari and I looked at Atiku. I voted for Atiku last year. I'm telling you what I did. This time around, I have voted all of them and I'm going to try something new. It is my right. It is my right.
Irrespective of your religion, your tribe, your party, I want you to listen to this woman carefully to the very end.
Responsibility to guide our congregation, if not for the whole Nigeria. And if the message is good enough for Nigeria, we will put it out there for Nigeria. Let me read two scriptures before I say what I want to say. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 10. When it goes well with the righteous, the city rejoices. And when the wicked perish, there is jubilation. Is that scripture? And then chapter 29, verse 2. Is that true? Is that true? We have had both of them. We have had some righteous people rule. And when I say righteous, it could be a Muslim, it could be a Christian. But people who believe to do right because it was right. Let me give you an example. When Yar'Adua came up to the throne, he publicly said that the elections that brought him to power were greatly flawed. You remember that? That is righteousness. That is saying the right thing, knowing that it was not a free and fair election that brought him. So a Muslim can be righteous, a Christian can be righteous. An unbeliever, somebody who doesn't even know God, profess any of the two religions, can also be righteous. The Bible says when these people are in authority, the city rejoices. The city rejoices. I believe that if Yar'Adua had a chance to live more, he could have corrected quite a few things because his right, his heart fundamentally was right. So when the righteous rule, the people rejoice. But when the wicked rules, there is groaning. I don't know that we have ever groaned like this in Nigeria. We have groaned. And the amazing thing about Nigerians is we forget. We forget. Some of you forget the people that have been killed in the last 4 years. You've forgotten it. And the thing about life is that if something is being repeated and repeated and repeated, after a while, we don't feel it anymore. But when it used to happen like that, we used to feel very pained until we have gotten used to the kidnap. Okay, it's kidnap. But then everyone is a serious case. I don't want you to forget where we are coming from. Because very soon, things will begin to ease off. Like banditry and security is beginning to ease off. And you would forget and think that it has always been like that. It has not always been like that. I want you to know that we are back to another political system and things will begin to ease off. And things will begin to ease off. You know why? So that we can vote for the same people. Please be advised. Be advised. Be advised. I won't be surprised if around December, January, rice comes down to 8,000 and things begin to ease and you forget. Please don't forget the last 8 years. I beg you in the name of God, don't forget the last 8 years. I also want you to remember that we got to a point in 2014 when we had it to hear with the reigning government at that time, when the corruption was so bad, when one person could take money and buy 12 bulletproof cars. When one of the ministers had so much jewelry that could feed a nation. And it got so bad that at that point we were crying, God, give us anybody. We forget. We forget. It was so bad that this government had ruled for over 10 years. And we were just crying. And that was what led us to choosing this government. Because at that point, Christians didn't care. Muslims didn't care. We just wanted a righteous man. We thought we wanted a righteous man, somebody who will bring us out of this corruption. That was why we voted. I'm reminding you of where we are coming from, so that you don't forget. So that you don't forget. Now we are at another cycle. And this cycle seems to be like God himself is doing the thing. Because what is happening right now is not the work of man. It's not the work of man. So even in our stupidity and in our foolishness and in our thinking, we know God is having mercy on us. I don't know that Nigerians have ever prayed for anything, for God to deliver us like this time. In fact, this time around, people are saying, even though I've never prayed for a president or an election, this time around, I am praying. I came to encourage you to not forget. That is the advantage of age, that you can see certain things and you can see certain patterns. And you can say, no, we did this before, it didn't work. We did this before, it worked. We did this before, it didn't work. So far, the last 8 years haven't worked. I don't care who says differently. Okay? And now they are going to do some things very quickly to make us forget, because we forget. And you know, politicians know the mindset. They have studied these things. They have studied it, so they think they can keep us like that. Long time ago, I used to stand here and say, it looks like we have been bewitched. But the bewitchment is being removed. The bewitchment is being removed. And we cannot continue to vote like we have been voting. Somebody accused me in this church that I hopped from PDP to APC and now I am in Labour. I can never belong to any party. I will never belong to any party. In fact, if you leave me, I hate parties and I don't hate politicians, but I don't like them. Because politics is just, I don't understand, why must politics be like that? Why must politics deceive? Why will you know that you will not do something and come out and say you will do it? Why must it be like that? So if you talk, they will say it's politics. Why must politics be bad? I am just looking for a righteous man. I am just looking for a good man. I am looking for somebody who will have compassion on the people and do what is right. And for crying out loud, what is right is not too much. All we're asking for is electricity. All we're asking for is road. All we're asking for is that there should be decent universities and that the universities should run. All we're asking for is good hospitals, that you should be able to go to a hospital and get medicine and get treated. All we're asking, just basic human things. And you know what? With the allowances that anybody in a high position gets, it's enough to keep you to live on. But when the greed becomes pathological, that is where we fight. I will never belong to a party. I will never register for any party. But I will keep looking for a good man. I will keep looking for a good man. I voted for Olusegun Obasanjo. I voted for Buhari the first time around. When I saw that first 4 years didn't work, I didn't vote for him the second time. In the absence of good and bad, between PDP and APC, I looked at Buhari and I looked at Atiku. I voted for Atiku last year. I'm telling you what I did. This time around, I have voted all of them and I'm going to try something new. It is my right. It is my right. And I know they say you shouldn't play politics in church. I am not playing politics. I just want right. So I don't belong to any party, but you have a right to belong to a party. I came this morning to plead with you under God that you forget your party as a child of God and vote for righteousness. Vote for righteousness. When there is righteousness, the Bible says the people rejoice. But when wicked people rule, the people groan. The same things that have been done over the years are being repeated. I want you to look at the people and vote your conscience. Vote for the people that will give us, the person that will give us some of these experiences that we have felt good about this morning. So that is my first message. My second message is that you can say shishi all you want. You can go to the streets and march all you want. If you do not go and collect your PVC, Aikin Banza. You know what Aikin Banza is? Nonsense work. Very, very nonsense. So if you do not go and get your PVC, we are going to go nowhere. These same people are going to come back and they will punish us again. So I came out this morning to tell you to go and get your PVC. Getting your PVC is as hard as registering, because they will try to frustrate you not to get the PVC. You need to line up there and collect your PVC by all means. Collect your PVC by all means. And this time, let us not vote for our convenience, our comfort, or our party. Let us vote for posterity. I want to be in the generation that will say, I was there and I spoke out that when Nigeria was changed. I want you to be among the people that say, I walked on the streets for Nigeria to be changed. I prayed on my knees for Nigeria to be changed. I did all I needed to do for Nigeria to be changed. I pray that you will not be one of those that will just vote because it's my party. You will not vote because it's my uncle. You will not vote because I will get something. Have you noticed that people have been getting something and the system is just getting worse? So this time, give up what you can get as an individual, and let us have what we can get as a community, as a collective polity. Amen? So go out there and collect your PVC. God bless you.